My name is Theresa Sukal-Moulton, and I'm a postdoctoral fellow in the Functional and Applied Biomechanics Laboratory, and I am working on a project looking at brain organization in children with cerebral palsy. We are very interested in this lab in studying movement and discoordinated movement following childhood onset brain injury. My hobbies have always been sports related and athletics related. Certainly in high school, I played a lot of sports. In college, even though I was an engineering major, I worked in the sports medicine department and worked with a lot of athletes. So the biomechanics of movement is always something that I've been interested in, and I think that's part of what led me to look at physical therapy as a different avenue of investigation and a different kind of viewpoint of movement disorders. We measure brain organization and activity using something called functional near-infrared spectroscopy to monitor which areas of the brain are the most active during different tasks. So we use the motion capture system within the laboratory to monitor how they're doing an activity, and then we use the lights to monitor why the activity is being done that way, or which areas of the brain are the most active when different tasks are being completed. So for a full setup for when somebody comes in here, it takes about 40 minutes to an hour to set it up. And then depending on the number of tasks that we ask them to do, it's about another hour or so of testing. Each task takes about 6 minutes, so it depends on how many tasks we're asking them to do. And so this sensor will measure the electrical activity occurring under there. Those cameras, as long as two of them can identify the marker in space, they can triangulate and locate the position of the markers within the lab. Any questions?
Nope.
Okay, great. My goal is to be an independent investigator, and I'm really fascinated by this line of inquiry, looking at how the brain works and how does it work when there's an injury, particularly early in development. You know, what happens and why do we move the way that we do because of that injury. So I see myself finding other people that have similar interests, the way that I have here with other postdocs, you know, with other independent investigators, and you know, working within maybe a research network kind of an idea. I think it would be very difficult to solve the problem of brain injuries. You know, it's something that other investigators that are very smart are working on, but I'm not sure that's something that we'll see in our lifetime. So I'm really working on understanding how does the brain adapt to those injuries, and can we modify the adaptation in a way that's most advantageous to the patient. You know, I'm very grateful to the mentors that I've had and the training that I've received over time. So I see myself as hoping to pass that forward to future scientists as they are doing their training. So I'd love to work with young people coming up and mentor them inside of my laboratory eventually.